We can do with your chain suggestions, please.
Holiday by Weezer was last on the chain. Think of something that links into that, please, and get in touch with us.
Yep, radcliffe.mcconey@bbc.co.uk, 64046 on the text. And put a phone number on, please. That, of course, was Sleeper with What Do I Do Now? And so...
Fresh from quite a few dates over the summer. I'm back on the road. I'm back playing live at a festival very soon. Is Sleeper. And here Louise joins us now. Morning, Louise.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you all?
We're all okay, thanks. So we're sort of semi-celebrating because this is our last show together, starting at 7 and then we start at 8. So what are mornings like for you at the weekend? Is this an early start?
It's an early start because I have teenagers now, so they sleep in really late.
Yeah.
It's not like getting up super early anymore. Yeah.
So you've been doing shows over the summer quite a lot, haven't you?
Yeah, we've been right around the country this summer. It was sort of weekend dates. It was really fun. I mean, they were sort of postponed like everything was. So we've been sort of waiting and waiting. And then you're sort of wondering every weekend whether they're actually going to happen, if something's going to stop it. But yeah, they've been amazing. Actually,
what made you do it again? I mean, was it sort of came to a time, you say your kids are teenagers, so they weren't so hands-on maybe, but what was it made you want to be in Sleeper again?
I mean, it wasn't something I wanted to do for a long time, and it just kind of, you know, I was coming up to 50 and I just wanted to get back on stage to see if I could and see what it was like, you know. And it was amazing. We made new music, we just went back onto a lot. And it was, we only planned to do sort of like one or two gigs, and you start and it feels so incredible.
And people want it. People are glad to see you.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the crowds have been amazing.
Great. Well, we'll talk some more about what's coming up for Sleeper. But first, last everything, we ask people for their first big enthusiasm, something recent and something that means a lot to them. We're going to start with Don't You Want Me by the Human League.
Banger for your first.
Tell us about this.
I bought Dare. That was the first album I went and bought with my own money. And I nearly didn't buy it because I wanted to buy some moon boots as well, which were like sort of 80s chunky snow boots, multicolored. Yeah. So I had the choice, moon boots or Dare by the Human League. And I had a Phil Oakey haircut, which was disastrous. I stand by it. And I bought Dare, and it was just, I loved it. I loved every single thing about it. And I thought maybe I'd go to a Sheffield disco once and be chosen to be in a Human League, because that's what happened to those girls. Every time I listened to it, I was like, maybe I could be in Human League, and that would happen to me.
So where were you growing up, and where would you have bought this?
I was in Ilford. I bought it in Ilford, Our Price, I'm pretty sure.
I
just remember going and choosing it, taking it home, seeing and looking at that cover.
Yeah.
You know, you love the first thing you buy, don't you?
Yeah. And then this is an acknowledged classic album, isn't it? Right at the beginning of the decade and hugely influential. Great, okay.
I was a pop kid,
All right then, so Louise Wenner's first is The Human League and Don't You Want Me.
From the album Dare, of course, Don't You Want Me, the first record bought by our guest this morning, Louise Wenner. So Louise, this time tomorrow with the last Sleeper record, so this was this a product of being in lockdown? That kind of stopped you touring, didn't it?
It did, obviously stop everyone touring, but This Time Tomorrow is like a collection of old songs, so it's kind of songs that we never released.
Yeah.
That we've been lying around on hard drives for years, and we're in lockdown and we thought, we've never sort of had the time to sort of develop them and produce them and sort of get them up to standard. And then we did that over lockdown and made them, you know, and put it out. I really love it, actually. I think they're lovely songs.
Well, have your kids been to see you this time?
They have. I mean, to be honest, they're much more stroppy about it now. When they first came, we started in 2017, I think, and they were a bit younger and more sort of pliable, and now they're like, oh my god, you can do that jumping around thing on stage again, mom. It's like this sort of, actually they're a brilliant sort of mix of kind of slightly thinking it's cool and also sort of mortified, yeah. Which I think is my job. I think that's my job, is to mortify them and make them think that it's sort of cool also.
Because it's not only their mum in the band, their dad's in the band.
Exactly. It's like mum and dad in the band, like, God, like, she's, you know, dragging us down the country to see your gigs through the summer, you know, it's kind of...
Because Andy's on the drums, isn't he? So,
I guess when you play... when you play live, is it a difficult, not difficult balancing act, but have you got to think, well, there'll be people who want to hear the old ones, and there'll be fans who want to hear the new ones, and we've got to sort of tread that middle ground or negotiate a way through that?
Yeah, I mean, you don't overthink it too much. I mean, we play new stuff, we play old stuff, yeah. And you make a nice combination of that. But in all honesty, just the gigs have been, they've just been really sort of, the atmosphere is really sort of quite joyful, you know, yeah. It feels like a celebration, especially after the last 18 months, you know, just getting back to live music and getting to play again. We walked out on our first gig in Newcastle, and it was just, everyone was just like elated, you know, it was a real moment.
Is it different, you know, as life is different, you know, obviously when you were young and on the road with a sleeper and you could go out and get leathered after the gig every night and, and you know, kind of, you know, get your early morning call in the bar in the morning and things. I mean, how is touring, is it in a way almost more enjoyable because the performance is sort of the visceral thrill, everything revolves around that?
Yeah, it is. It's all about the gig. And also, I'm not self-conscious about it in the way that I was in the 90s. It was like you spent your whole time sort of trying to impress everyone and sort of wondering what your position in the world is. And you just, you know, none of that is there anymore. And everyone's much better behaved. So, you know, half of us are vegans, you know, no one drinks. you know, there's lots of that. So it's not kind of, you're not still trying to get wrecked every night. It's just, it's a different kind of fun.
Yeah. Tell us about Parquet Courts.
Yeah, I mean, it's strictly not the last thing I bought, but I was listening to it a lot this summer. I just think this is such a lovely album, Human Performance, and it's sort of romantic and quirky and clever, but the tunes are just great. And this song, I think, this song is so lovely and romantic. I think I feel when I hear it that this would be the song that I would slow dance to with my partner when I was, like, in my 80s. That's the kind of vibe it gives me. I just think it's gorgeous. And it's very Sunday morning, I think.
Okay, great. Parquet Courts, Human Performance.
I know exactly where I was when I first saw you, the way I see you now, through these eyes, waiting to retry. Those pristine days I recall so fondly, so few are the trials when a life isn't lonely.
Human Performance by Parquet Courts, a recent and current favourite of our guest Louise Wenner. So, Louise, a couple of weeks, I guess, away, you'll be playing this big festival in Sunderland.
Yeah, Sunderland Cubics Festival on Saturday, the 2nd of October. I'm really looking forward to it, actually. We've done only a couple of festivals this year. Because, again, lots of things got moved around. This one has been moved, I think, twice, maybe.
Right.
But yeah, Ding Festival is super lovely.
Levellers are on and Future Heads, Peter Hook and the Light, all kinds of people,
I've been to a couple of big outdoor shows recently in the last couple of weeks, and what I hadn't realised is the things you would never think you'd feel you missed. Plastic glasses, people standing around outside. You suddenly realise how much, in fact, you've missed it.
Yeah, the stupidest things. It's just, it's just the atmosphere, isn't it? Just sort of standing amongst a huge crowd of people and just seeing those faces. Very, very uplifting, I think.
Are you writing? Because obviously you've had another career as a writer with the novels and the autobiography and some TV writing and things. So what are you working on anything?
Yeah, I'm doing a bit of writing. I'm doing a bit of sort of TV script writing. So I'm sort of working on a few bits for that. And the music, family's keeping me pretty busy.
Great. We should say that, the festival that we're talking about, Cubics Festival, Harrington Park, Sunderland, Saturday the 2nd of October and Friday the 8th, but the Saturday the 2nd is when Sleeper play.
Yeah. Well, it's on the 8th of October as well, the Venger Boys and Two Unlimited as well, and Bewitched. Would you rather have been on that day, really, Louis?
happy with my day.
Of course, yeah, yeah.
Great. And this time tomorrow, as you said, was a sort of collection of older tunes and including a collaboration with George Michael.
Yes, it has George Michael singing a little backing vocal on one of his songs, because we recorded a lot of it at his studio in Highgate.
Yeah,
and they were just sort of like lost, you know, songs that we'd recorded and never released.
Yeah. Was in his studio, did he sort of stick his nose in and see how things were going, and one thing led to another?
It was exactly that, and he came in and he really liked this one song. It's called We Are Cinderella. And he goes, I like that. Maybe I'll sort of do a little backing vocal. Like, do you mind?
He said, no, you're all right, George.
I remember he was doing it, and obviously he sounded glorious. And he was like, does that sound right? Is it okay? You know, it was a lovely moment. It's a nice
song. Great. And will there be, and then will there be more Sleeper recorded material?
I think so. We're sort of writing and doing more stuff. I mean, it's hard to stop when you get that bug back, I think. I think writing stuff is my favourite thing to do. You know, it's just kind of conjuring songs out of nowhere. It's just the loveliest thing. Yeah.
And John's still with you, isn't it? The original guitar player and you met at Manchester Uni all those years ago?
Yeah. It's been a long time now.
Yeah.
We'll look forward to it then. So Sleeper, but more pressingly, Cubics Festival, Harrington Park, Sunderland, Saturday the 2nd October. Sleeper will be playing. You're everything, Louise, that you've chosen for us. Born to Run, Bruce Springsteen.
Yes. I mean, I feel like of all the classic albums I own, that's been around in my life forever. It sort of came out when I was 9 years old, and I've just always loved it. It's kind of that epicness, the drama, it's storytelling. It's a bit sort of showbiz as well, I think, you know, and I was kind of so in love with American culture, and I don't know what I thought about it when I was a kid, you know, I thought I was Wendy, you know, I thought I was this escapism, this like big landscapes, there were heroes and heartbreak and it's sort of everything.
One of the extraordinary things about this record, I think, is when you see it written down, you see the duration, 4 minutes 28. It feels like a 10-minute epic, doesn't it?
It does, but I have this sort of rule that, you know, obviously another track on the album, Thunder Road, if someone can sing all the lyrics start to finish without making a mistake, I'm pretty sure I can be mates with them.
Right. Yeah. But you're absolutely right, it is showbiz. It's a big showbiz record, isn't it, Born to Run?
Right. Yeah.
Well, it's always a pleasure. We'll hear it now. And lovely to talk to you, Louise.
Thank you.
Yeah, all right. Cheers. Thanks
Bye-bye.
Very much.
Bye.
So I was just talking to Loz, it's just about 2 years since she and I went to London to meet Bruce to talk about his wonderful album, Western Stars. And I remember asking him, if you could save one of your albums from a fire, one favourite album, which one would it be? And he said Nebraska. But he said, and then he said, yeah, maybe Born to Run.
Well, I think, one thing most people would say Born to Run from his back catalog, wouldn't it? Just been that great bit in The Sopranos where Christopher is late and he says, I'm sorry I'm late, the highway was jammed with broken heroes on a last chance power drive.
that was an everything from Louise Wenner of Sleeper. Sleeper are on at the Cubics Festival at Harrington Park, Sunderland on Saturday the 2nd of October.
And Mike in Sheffield says, growing up in St Helens, Durr was one of those LPs that even at the age of 5 was catchy. Not quite sure why growing up in St Helens got to end up, but probably this is why I ended up in Sheffield, says Mike in Sheffield.
Right, OK. Thanks again to Louise Wenner for being our first Last Everything guest today.
On BBC iPlayer.
We didn't have much, but we were really happy.
A pioneering three-part documentary series from the Academy Award-winning director Steve McQueen.
Just before 6 o'clock this morning, the singing and dancing gave way to panic.
Three events intertwined. The new Crossfire.